is nutrition? Yes, it means in the first semester. Already in second chapter you have learned what is nutrition. And girl, you also came to know that every organism is made up of a small structural and function unit called cell. Is it? Now, I am going to tell a story about two friends and their grandparents. Okay? You just imagine yourself, you are walking along with your grandparents. And your grandparents asking you to reach the home faster. What will you do? Automatically, we run towards our home. Is it? Here also, those two friends ran to their home. After running, they were breathing rapidly. Is it? We are breathing rapidly after running. Why it happens? Then, what is actually breathing? Yes, my dears, in today's class, we shall discuss about respiration in organisms. Breathing is nothing but respiration. Is it? Breathing in and out. Regularly we are breathing air. Is it? Which type of air? That is, we intake oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. We intake oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. Whether this breathing happens only with the nostril or nose or with all other parts of our body? Yes, my dears, it is not happening only with our nose. All other parts of our body or all other cells which are in your body will breathe together with the nostrils. Is it? Well, then what is a cell? Cell means it is the basic unit of life. It is a structural and functional unit of life. Why we are using two terms here, structural and functional? Just because it gives the structure to our body and also it performs so many functions, just like respiration, transportation, excretion and absorption. Okay, all these are the functions of cell. A single unit of cell or a microscopic cell can perform all other functions which are done by the organ system. Okay, next one is cellular respiration. What is cellular respiration? Yes, my dears, I have told you that not only the nostrils, each and every unit of cell in every organism will respire. Is it? So, what is cellular respiration means? The respiration which takes inside the cell, or the respiration which takes inside the cell by breaking down the food to release energy. Okay? The respiration which takes place inside the cell or with the breakdown of food to release energy is called cellular respiration. Means respiration starts with the small unit of every organism, that is cell. Okay, it starts with the cell. There also the food what we eat will break down and it releases some amount of energy. Already you know that mitochondria is also called as powerhouse of the cell, just because it releases energy. Is it? Yes, my dears. Next is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. There are two types of cellular respirations. Okay, that is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. We know that what is cellular respiration, but what about aerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration means the word itself, the symbols that aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of air. In the presence of air means here the air which we breathe in. The air which we breathe in. Which type of air we are breathing? Yes, that is nothing but, answer is right. Yes, my dear, oxygen. Is it? We breathe in oxygen. Here, in the presence of oxygen, if our food is break down and it gives us energy, then it is called as aerobic respiration. Okay, what is aerobic respiration? Once again, I will repeat it. Aerobic respiration means here the breakdown of food takes place in the presence of oxygen by releasing carbon dioxide, water and energy. Okay, what it will release? It releases carbon dioxide, water and energy. You know that we breathe out carbon dioxide. Where it is from? It is just because when food is break down, it releases some amount of energy along with the releasing of carbon dioxide and water. Okay, this is called as aerobic respiration. question here. Glucose means the food which we eat. Okay, glucose means the food which we eat. Every food, the food which we eat contains glucose. Okay, here glucose in food in the presence of oxygen break down and it releases carbon dioxide, water and energy. This is called as aerobic respiration. Then what is anaerobic respiration? You know that this is the opposite of aerobic respiration. Okay, aerobic, anaerobic means here anaerobic means in the absence of air or in the absence of oxygen. Here air means nothing but oxygen. Okay, while you are talking about respiration, we should consider air as an oxygen. Okay, remember my dear, this is very important. And aerobic respiration means it takes place in the absence of oxygen. Anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. Here in the absence of oxygen, glucose or the food which we eat breaks down and releases some amount of energy. In which type of organisms will this anaerobic respiration take place? Yes, my dears, have you observed some organisms? So when we kept some food inside a box and we tightly thread it, but still some organisms, microorganisms have developed on it, just like the yeast. Is it yeast or some other microorganisms? They will respire in the absence of air or in the absence of oxygen. Okay, those are called as anaerobic respiration animal or anaerobic respiration organisms. Okay, here anaerobic respiration organisms example is yeast. Okay, yeast is an example for anaerobic respiration. Why? In the absence of oxygen, yeast respire and it gives out energy and also alcohol along with carbon dioxide. Okay, means in the absence of oxygen, food is break down and it releases alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy. Alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy. What about human beings? Yes, my dear, do you think that human beings also respire anaerobically? Is it possible for us without oxygen, can we respire? No, it's not possible, is it? But still, it is possible. And you are respiring without oxygen for some time. Okay? Only for a short time. Only for a short time. But what time? At what time you are respiring like that? Yes, my dears. When temporarily, when there is a temporarily deficiency of oxygen in our body during heavy exercise, where while we are doing heavy exercise or cycling or walking or many more heavy things, heavy weight lifting, like that, what we are doing, all these exercises are at that time, at that certain period of time, what happens? There is a deficiency of oxygen in our body. At that time, we breathe for a temporary moment anaerobically. Without oxygen you are breathing. Okay, for that it will produce, what it produces at the time during anaerobic respiration, it produces lactic acid and energy. What it will produce during anaerobic respiration? Food is break down into lactic acid and energy in human beings. In human beings, food is break down into lactic acid and energy during anaerobic respiration. When this anaerobic respiration takes place in human beings? Yes, my dears, in human beings it takes place temporarily for a short time while we are doing heavy exercise or heavy weight lifting or heavy walking or running or cycling. Okay, what is the effect of this anaerobic respiration? What is the effect? Yes, my dears, have you ever wondered why you get muscle cramps? Why you get muscle cramps while doing heavy exercise or while cycling, while running or while walking briskly? Is it? Have you observed what is meant by cramps? Muscle cramps? Muscle cramps means it leads to swelling of muscles or it leads to paining of muscles. While doing heavy exercise, so we come across all those things. Why this happens means this is just because of anaerobic respiration which takes place in our body during the heavy exercise. There we know that lactic acid will be produced. Is it? We know that lactic acid will be produced. Here the partial breakdown of glucose produces lactic acid. Is it the partial? It does not break down completely just because of absence of oxygen. Is it? It breaks down partially. Lactic acid is break down partially, and it causes muscle cramps. Okay, it causes muscle cramps. Yes, my dears, we get relief from the muscle cramps when we take a hot water bath or when we apply some kind of oil and make it rubbing by rubbing the oil on the muscle. Is it? Why is it happening? Why we are taking the hot water bath or we apply some hot oil massage like that? Why? Yes, just because when we use hot water or a hot oil massage, when we are taking hot bath or a hot oil massage, at that times it improves the circulation of blood. Okay, it improves the circulation of blood. At that moment, as a result, the supply of oxygen in the muscles, increases automatically when the blood circulation is take place there. When it improves the circulation of blood there, automatically here the deposition of this lactic acid, where actually we are getting pain at that moment, lactic acid is deposited there. When the blood circulation takes place, this lactic acid converted into simpler substances just like carbon dioxide, water. Okay, it is as a result in the complete breakdown of this lactic acid takes place, means it is converted into carbon dioxide and water again. So we get relief from the pain. Okay, so we get relief from the pain while we get muscle cramps while we are doing heavy exercises. At that time, what is the measure we have to take? We have to take the hot water bath or hot oil massage to improve the blood circulation in the space. Okay, in that space we have, should improve the blood circulation, and it leads to the relief from the pain. Okay, my dears, this is all about things what we have learned today. We have learned the cell, the functions of cell, what is breathing, and two types of breathing, that is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. And also we have come across two things here in anaerobic respiration. Example is yeast, and another one is human beings. Human beings respire anaerobically only for a short time. Okay, my dears, go through the textbook, read twice or thrice, then you can understand